My first remarks this morning, the wonderful occasion of greeting people coming in, it was a little one being carried in by Mom Isabella. She was watching what was going on, and then in the back here, Matilda this morning, who seemed more focused on the fan than she was on me. This is the season of new life. I am going fishing. That's what Simon Peter said. I'm going fishing. So he had left Jerusalem, and so did the others, and they left the upper room, but they needed to take a break. And that was his business. And fishing all night and catching nothing, they're interrupted by this man on the shore who calls to them and says and addresses them as children and cast your net off the right side. Been at it all night long, they didn't catch nothing. They did it. It must have happened, because I'm thinking, who would have counted to 153? So it was remarkable, and they remembered it. This man on the shore who had the fire going said, bring some of what you just caught. And they had breakfast. Then the dialogue with Simon Peter. Oh, bringing back the memories, the denials, but now the affirmation, do you love me? Henry Nouwen, who I like to read, and C.S. Lewis also, I love his stuff. C.S. Lewis's brother remarked that his brother would have been more prolific if he hadn't to take care of his disabled stepmother. And so he did the chores and he did the shopping. But C.S. Lewis didn't see it that way. I want to talk to you about interruptions. Interruptions. That's what this person on the shore did. He interrupted them. And how do you handle it? How do you handle the phone ringing when you don't want it to ring? Or the knock on the door? How do you handle these kind of interruptions that are part of living? It's the interruptions, that Nouwen said, that provided him with the inspiration for his writing. It's the interruptions that are the hallmark, and how we handle it, of our encounters with the Lord or of announcing the good news to others. You know, all of us have our plans, right? We set out and we've got 10 things to do today, and if I get 3 of them done, I'm lucky, right? And then there's the interruptions. The unplanned things. Well, this is the challenge to you and me. How do we handle those kind of interruptions? They are graced events. They are the cause and inspiration of the other. That's my first bullet point. How do you handle the interruptions? My second is this. You have been part of the faith. You have been disciples of Jesus. You've been baptized. You've been confirmed. You've been attending service. You're doing everything you were supposed to do as disciples. When do you graduate? What do I mean? Well, the same thing I would think could have been said to the apostles. They were all disciples of Jesus, and they all were at his feet, and they all traveled with him, as it was a custom with rabbinic teachers and inspirational people. They drew disciples. They drew followers, followers, followers. And they all studied, and then he left. And it was the occasion of the outpouring of the Spirit and other events that happened in Jerusalem that brings us back to the first reading of today. The book of Acts. The arrest of the disciples of Jesus, who considered it now a privilege to be using his name. See, there's a difference, and this is my second bullet point. The transfer of us from being followers of Jesus to being missionaries of Jesus. You accept the mission of Jesus, then you act out in your life the mission of Jesus in whatever encounters you have. You are no longer a follower, you're a graduate. You say, This is my mission now. I accept the mission of Jesus. And what is that mission? Well, it's exactly what the Lord said to Peter. Feed them. Feed them. Feed them. There was one grandmother coming in with three little ones this morning, and she reminded me of my own mother. And I said, well, they're all here with you. And she said, yes. Otherwise, they don't get their donuts. My mother served two meals on Sunday, brunch and early dinner. And she said it at that time so that the ones who went to church ate when they got back from church, and the ones who were out Saturday night got up and ate and then went to 12 o'clock. But you had to do one or the other, or she wouldn't feed you. You are a graduate. You are missioners of Christ. You have accepted that mission, and you bring that mission to the world. It's time to grow up. So first, how do you deal with the interruptions of your life and make them redemptive? In graced moments, who would take you in directions you didn't think you were ever going to go, it wasn't on your agenda, and how those are the graced events of God in our lives and possibilities. And second, you are no longer just sitting here spectators. You are participants. You are the body of Christ in the world. Amen.